Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. We're here today beginning work on refurbishing, I guess, doing a little maintenance and stuff on my 1978 John Deere Liquifire. If you've seen a few videos back now, I did a little preview of some of the work that we have to get done here. It's finally time. The weather has been so good, I just haven't wanted to be in the garage working on anything. It's been so nice outside for a while. But we are now the latter part of November. The weather is terrible today. It is pouring rain outside. And it's a great day to be stuck inside the garage doing some work. So we won't be digging into the machine too much today. But we will be putting together a new snowmobile lift that I picked up. Just so I don't have to be rolling around on the floor. And that should make life a little bit easier for us as we start to work. So here's what we've got on the go today. This is a snowmobile lift that I picked up from Princess Auto here in Canada. Would be similar, I guess, to Harbor Freight maybe in the United States. Here's the details on the thing. Load capacity of 800 pounds, lift height, maximum lift, overall dimensions. So this ran me $170 or so, all taxes in, on sale. So we're going to tear into this and start putting it together, see how it works out, and maybe we'll do a test lift on the machine in a little bit. So let me get out some tools and we'll cut into this and see how it goes. So here in the box, we've got some instructions. Looks like we've got parts and pieces, bag of hardware here, wheels for the bottom. So I'll start disassembling some of this and we will have a look through the instructions, see what this is going to take. Doesn't look like it should be too much trouble. Hopefully we'll be able to have this underneath the machine fairly soon. Stand by. All right, so we've got everything unboxed. Those are the main heavy pieces still laying on the floor there. And here on the makeshift workbench, we've got all of our hardware. We've got brackets here for attaching these casters to the underside. So far, everything feels pretty well heavy duty. Everything is powder coated with this nice blue powder coat. The only thing I might suggest, and we'll see how it works once we get it going, is these casters, a little bit small. So I don't know how they're gonna work rolling around on the floor. They might be okay, but we will cross that bridge when the time comes. So I'm gonna set you guys up on some time lapse and we will start putting this together and see how that goes. Fingers crossed. Turn this upside down.
right, we are on to the last one. I'm gonna move my high-tech lift here. That piece of wood will be headed for the stove, the fireplace this afternoon, just because it is kind of damp and cold and miserable out, and that just seems like a good idea for later on. Let me get these tightened up. Some of you are probably thinking, why isn't he using an impact or power driver or something? And you know what? That's a good question. It is right over there on the shelf. But every once in a while, I like to use the ratchets and the wrenches. Just gives you a little more feeling of being connected to what you're assembling, I guess. I don't know. I don't know how you guys feel about that. But it's kind of nice to do that. The whole snowmobile thing is a nostalgia thing for me. My dad had one, exactly the same model back in the day. His was brand new. Mine is, you know, coming on to 50 years old now. But he always, when he had to work on it, he used the hand tools. So I guess it's kind of that kind of way for me too. All right, so here are the instructions that I've been following. As you can see, the diagrams are not super duper clear. So it does take a few minutes to read through all of the text, figure out which part you're actually looking for, and at what point to attach it. So I'm going to take a minute and kind of lay things out a little quick here, loosely put the bolts together, and we'll show you what that looks like in a second. Okay, so there's most of it together. We still have to put on the piston, but that is all loosely set up. Couple of spots there would have been useful to have an extra set of hands, I think, just to kind of get some stuff lined up, but a couple of little pieces of wood keep you from, jamming your fingers, which is not the greatest thing to do in the world when you're trying to do these things together. So that helped a bit. So I guess according to the instructions here, the only thing left to do is put on the piston, get that in place, and then we'll get all this tightened up. We'll probably go for the impact with these ones just to speed things up a little bit. So we'll get you guys set up someplace where you can watch, and we'll get that done.
Gonna go the right way, guys. Not tightening these up super tight because we need to see how it's gonna flex and where it might need to move some. So getting them down so they're close, and then we'll see where it goes from there once we get the piston up. As I'm doing this, I'm thinking about these washers. I'm wondering if potentially I shouldn't have put those in between each of the members to reduce binding, but I guess we will see how that goes here in a minute. I'm getting close. Now, gotta get a smaller ratchet, a smaller socket. Give me a sec. The nut on this side is too tight against the little tab that they have, so it looks like we might have to go about that a different way. And back to the hand socket. Made a mistake. This is gotta be underneath. So I'm gonna zip this off again, drop this down underneath, and that will allow this to come out underneath so that the snowmobile can actually fit on the lift. That might be a good plan. All right, give me 1 second. We'll switch this around.
makes a little bit more sense. This is where an extra set of hands. Now, how is this going to work?
All right, technical difficulties. Give me a moment. All right, so the time has come. I'll get everything tightened up, I think. Had a quick look around, didn't see anything that was not there. So we've got our handy dandy lifter. Get this on and see how this goes. Well, so far so good. My only concern, and obviously I think I'm going to rig up something with a drill or an impact here to do this a little quicker. My only concern is this angle here. This will sit underneath the engine bay of the machine, but I'm worried about the clearance here between here and the front of the snowmobile. So we'll have to kind of play with that a little bit, see what's happening. But so far so good. Looks like everything is working. I'm going to make sure I get a little shot of grease in here. We want that working well. Feels pretty stable. I am sitting on cardboard here, not on the floor. So it's pretty heavy. It's heavy gauge steel. Couple of little things that I've noticed just putting it together. This rubber strip along the top. I don't know who put that on, but it's a little uneven, to say the least. So that might have to be adapted or changed at some point in the future. We'll see. Really, the only thing left to put on are the levelers here in the back, and they just drop into these pre-mounted nuts that are welded into the frame. So we'll just tighten those down as far as they'll go for now, and then we can use them to level the machine a bit later on. This one here, oh, sorry guys, can't see anything when you're looking at the floor. This one here has got some rubber coating still left on the threads. So I'm going to take a second. I'll clean those up. We'll drop this back in. And then I'm going to swing the machine around so it's facing towards us. We'll slide this underneath, see how this is going to work. Be right back. All right, sorry about that, guys. I ran into a couple of little technical difficulties as far as where I had placed stuff. Dealing with the instructions as they were, sometimes the images aren't quite as clear, so I had to take some time and go back and have a look at what was happening. When I did try to test this, you'll see we are up in the air. When I did try to test this, I had to make a few changes. One was these rear wheels, the rear casters. I did have them coming out this way, outboard. Had to move them inboard just so that they could clear the skis. There wasn't enough clearance on the inside to get them in, so I moved those inboard. I also flipped these brackets upside, or I had them on upside down, I will admit. Had to flip them the other way to lower the clearance here from the top of the rails to the floor. It gave me a little more clearance, which allowed me to get underneath the machine a little bit better. But success
It is up in the air. It is stable. It does move. There is a little bit of movement. I do have to tighten up a few more of those bolts just to get it the way I want it. But this should give us lots of room. Save the back a little bit from having to bend over all the time or laying on the floor. The bumper itself is up at about waist height. This is the full extent of the lift. So that's great. Really cuts down on having to bend over and lean over on the back. Couple of little snags. You'll remember earlier I was mentioning I was worried about this screw lift here. There's a big screw in here. As you turn it, it lifts it up. Was a little worried about clearance with the bumper. That was a bit of an issue, as the crank handle that they provide comes up. Let's see if I can get this on one-handed. As it comes up, it will at certain points make contact with the bumper. So I'll have to remember that, watch that. Simple matter of either just extending this out so that it clears, or what I did today was just put the ratchet on with a 22 mil socket and just turned her up. So that worked out all right. I will have to play a little bit with placement here of where I want the lift to make contact with the underside of the snowmobile, just so that I have it in a spot that's the most stable it can be and doesn't come into contact with anything I don't want it to. One last challenge is that those casters at the back, now that they've been moved inboard of the outside rails, they do come into contact with the track as it slides underneath. So what I had to do was lift the back of the snowmobile up to get those slid back under. Not a big deal, just a little extra step that we'll have to be aware of and make allowances for as we work. But that's gonna be about it for today with this. We will jump back into this machine. First task will be doing some dismantling of some of the parts inside. Hopefully we'll have enough snow this year that I can get back out on it. Last year we didn't have enough snow on the ground to even bother turning the key. So anyway, stay tuned. We will be back into this. If you have any interest in vintage snowmobiles and especially John Deere snowmobiles, feel free to like the videos, share them with friends if you know someone who has one or is interested, and also subscribe because it helps me out. I don't do this for money, but it's kind of nice to know that people are out there having a watch. And thank you to all you guys who have already liked the videos and made comments. So hope everybody's doing well. We will see you on the next one.